Hey everybody, XCI for Blind Let's Play of Dragon Age Origins. Here we have the new group. We have Xander, we have Alistair. Well, these are the same, Morgan, but the new person right now is Zevran. And I feel like putting Stan on the group now that we're walking around a city, and based on some comments that I've gotten about how personal dialogue options only open up when you drag them along, because they start having they start communicating with each other and opening up those pieces that you overhear, and then you talk to them about those pieces. So I think before I push any further and accidentally start anything, I'm going to do a party reset by leaving the zone and coming back in. I hope this works. I mean, I don't care if it... What? Oh boy. So there's a bunch of different districts in... What is that? What is... So it just tells me where fights are going down? Are these like gang wars? What is this? Okay, I just oh crap, I'm gonna have to leave. Some can I just say to come back? Can I just do this? Please just let me do this the easy way. Alright, so what I think I actually need to do is go to the party camp and then go back to Denerim.
I lied to you, you know, about why I left.
Oh my god, I didn't mean to kickstart this, but I'll take it. Oh, that she looks so like uncomfortable right now. Oh, Liliana, I love your honesty, and I'm worried about your acting. The voice acting is great. That the character is hiding something. Why? I knew you weren't telling me something, so you didn't get tired of the life? So you didn't get tired of the life? I really don't care why you left. Xander would care. He feels like, you know, to make a unit work together, you gotta be... I love how he's pacing like that. I love that it's just out of focus. That looks so good, man. Yeah, to work well as a team, you gotta be honest with each other, you know? I knew you weren't telling me something. I'm just gonna go for it. Xander style.
I didn't feel like talking about it then. What happened to me? Maybe it will affect us. Maybe not, but you should know. I came to Ferelden and the Chantry because I was being hunted in Orlais.
I'm still okay with that. We can help with that problem. Hunted? What for? You're a criminal? Fascinating. Tell me more. Well, I don't know what fascinating, but... hunted? What for?
I was framed.
Oh, see?
Betrayed by someone I thought I knew and could trust.
No problem, man. We can fix this.
Marjolaine. She was my mentor and friend. Uh-huh. She taught me the bardic arts. How to enchant with words and song, to carry myself like a highborn lady, to blend in as a servant. The skills I learned, I used to serve her, my bardmaster, because I loved her, and because I enjoyed what I did.
How did she betray you? So Marjolaine was a bard too, so you were dutiful, but you still got in trouble. You loved her. How does she betray? I don't know if I'd get emotional on this part right here. More like Xander would be like, okay, what are the facts first? Let's get all those out. Then let's get emotional about things, or react emotionally, you know? How, he's very logical at the start. How did she betray you?
You can say it was my fault. There was a man I was sent to kill. I was to bring Marjolaine everything he carried. I don't know who this man was. She gave me a name and a description, and I hunted him down. I found documents on his body, sealed documents.
You opened them, didn't you? Important documents? Is this story going somewhere? Important documents? You opened them, didn't you? I don't think I'd care. Xander wouldn't care if she opened them. Because he doesn't care about the whole, like, the bard and assassin thing. It doesn't really feel right to him, but... Tasks are tasks, but important documents?
It turns out that they were. My curiosity got the better of me. Something told me that I needed to know what was in those letters. Marjolaine had been selling all kinds of information about Orlais to other countries. Yeah. Nivara and Antiva among others. It was treason.
Well, I don't know. Bards be bards. Isn't that the whole point of bards? Is that they're spies? Or is it treason because they're normally spies for Orlais, but this one was going, she was helping outside forces. So it's just Orlais. Isn't that what bards do? Okay, so it is an option. Is this a bard thing? That's what Xander would be thinking. Isn't that what bards do?
Some. But I had always assumed Marjolaine only operated within Orlais. This was an unhappy surprise for me. My life as Bard taught me that my loyalties should be kept fluid. My concern was not that she was a traitor, but that her life would be in danger if she was caught. Orle has been at war with so many countries, it takes a harsh view of such things, as I later discovered.
What do you mean? I can see where this is going. Well, most countries don't appreciate treason. Did you give the documents to someone? I'm just gonna ask.
I should have left well alone, but I didn't. I had to tell Marjolaine I feared for her life. She brushed aside my concern. She admitted her guilt, but said it was in the past. That is why the documents had to be destroyed, she said.
Yeah.
I believed her. I kept believing up till the moment they showed me the documents, altered by her hand, to make me look the traitor.
Who's they? What happened then? She betrayed you. Who's they? Xander, who's they?
The Orlesian guards.
Deal with this.
They captured me.
It wouldn't be their fault.
Terrible.
Oh, Jesus.
To make me confess and reveal my conspirators. It was a traitor's punishment I endured. And at the end of it, all that awaited me was eternity in an unmarked grave.
Well, it wouldn't be the guard's fault, you know? It'd be this bitch right here. That'd be brought down. Okay, so. I can't believe I just like. No, Xander. No emotion. How did you get out? How unpleasant. And you never sought revenge on Marjolaine for this? I mean, Xander's not really. No, he kind of is. If someone screws someone like Xander. Nah, he's not. It's not like he wouldn't go out of his way, but if he crossed paths. It'd be difficult to sway Xander. Well, I mean, but then there's Zevran, who tried to kill him, and then Xander gave him a shot. No, Xander's got a weak spot for people looking for redemption. But this chick put her through something rough, and it wasn't... That's a little bit... This is a sketch. So... But what do you ask about if someone's vengeful? She doesn't seem like a vengeful type. Liliana, how unpleasant... How did you get out?
This kills Marjolaine taught me we're good for something, at least. I broke free when I saw the opportunity. I did not seek Marjolaine out. If she thought I was coming for her, she would have me caught again.
What the... And so you came to Ferelden to Lothering. I don't think you would have... Oh, been caught again. I don't think you would have been caught again. And so you ran away like a coward. No. Hold on. And so you came to Ferelden to Lothering.
I was tempted to confront her. I was furious, betrayed. But what could I do against her? And so I fled to Ferelden, to the Chantry and the Maker. Ferelden protected my person, and the Maker saved my soul. And that is the reason I am here. The real reason. No more lies between us, at least in this.
I'm so closely aligned to this chick right now. It's to just be open about things, unless she's still lying to me. But I feel like she's not, and she's definitely, the whole Maker story is panning out to her because she really feels like that was a savior for her in that part of her life. But, because having you here a threat to us, Xander wouldn't care about that. He would, anybody who agrees to be part of this family, he would treat as family. Thank you for trusting me with this. Your past is going to catch up to you eventually. You'll be safe in my company. That sounds like I would take personal ownership over her safety. That's not the Xander way. The Xander way is unite people together and then create the companionship that is like all for one. You know what I mean? All for one and one for all sort of thing. I wouldn't take this as a personal in my company. It's in our company. I wish that wasn't phrased that way. Like, I think she can take care of herself. Xander's more like, you know, everyone needs someone to have their back. And I would be that person. But I wouldn't own that directly like that. Your past is going to... Thank you for trusting me with this. I might just go with this. Is having you here a threat to us? He wouldn't care. So thank you for trusting me with this, or he will be safe in my company. No, I don't want to say that just because I don't feel right saying it. I mean, I feel like this is the right feeling. It's the right feeling behind the answer, but I don't like the way it's worded, and I'm going to RP my way to this one. Just because that's not a good... If it says our... You got what I'm saying. Okay, so...
It feels good to have this off my chest. Thank you for listening and understanding.
Liliana's kind of like I feel like I could have a sister-brother relationship with her. Like, it's not... There's nothing really romantically or sexually motivating Xander to care about this girl, but he feels like she's a good person, you know? And she's, out of all of these people, probably the most innocent. I wouldn't even give that to Alistair. Alistair's like... I think he had the potential in him to become a Templar dick. And I don't... That's not... Nah. Mog is the most innocent. Okay, let's do what I actually planned on doing, which is gather the party. I'm going to get Sten on here. Yes. I'm going to get Zev on here. Yes. And I'm going to get... I think Morgan. I'm growing on Morgan here. So... She's told me a lot. I'm close to her. Alistair, I could take a break from. I'm going to go out with Morgan.
Indeed.
Yeah, let's do this. Because we're walking through the Denerim at this point. So I feel like what could go wrong in Denerim where I need to know how to fight. I'll just, who cares? I'll learn how to fight as I go. I'm doing a four-person team, which I've never...
Your mother is supposedly as the one called Flemeth, the very witch from legend. Is that not true?
There is nothing supposed about it. Flemeth is my mother.
They are sinners who now have it's more doubtful of the legend rather than your relationship to this woman. Anyone can claim a name, after all.
You're welcome to ask her if you ever meet her. You're just her type.
Oh, elven and handsome?
The sort that will never be missed.
Jesus.
Sounds intriguing, if you ask me.
You assassin types have a death wish, I see.
Only the really good ones.
Good lord. Yeah, I had to get away from these ladies here because that conversation was made more important.
Magic,
nah, I don't care.
To serve man,
I get it.
Never
you're
to
gonna miss quoting. Now I'm
foul
curious
and
again.
Corrupt are they who have taken
damn it.
His gift and turned it against his
can't
children.
Help it.
They shall be named Maleficar, accursed ones. They shall find no rest in this world.
Is she not messing up anymore?
I was getting to that.
Oh, she's continuing for her. Wow, how long does that go? Okay, let's pick up some Chanter Board quests here. We got Back Alley Justice. Oh, that was what was showing on the map. Because I clicked on this and then clicked away or something. I don't know. But let's read these out because they're quests and yeah, there's no point in summarizing these. So Back Alley Justice. Eliminate the criminals preying on innocent folk in Denerim's back alleys. In these dark times, we must work together against the common threat. Sergeant Kylon has brought disturbing news that should anger all righteous people. In our own alleyways, footpads? That was a footpad. Like, place of living? I don't know. Alleyways, footpads, muggers. Oh, is that like a slang term for... Doesn't matter. Muggers and miscreants lie in wait to profit from the chaos of our times. They infect us like a plague. A reward is available for any information on these low lives. Sergeant Kylon. I need to pick one. Let's go Kylon. Sergeant Kylon has also offered a heavy purse for any brave souls that can best the brigands and make Denerim a safe place once again. This humble chanter has added to the reward as well. May the maker bless all who heed this call. Except, missing in action. Recently, our hearts were lifted when many survivors of the Battle of Ostagar returned to us. I thought no one survived the Battle of Ostagar. Are they talking about the ones that betrayed with Terran Loghaine? Are they traitors? Like, are there traitors in the city? Oh, wait. Yeah, no, they did come to the city. What am I talking about? Okay. Makers bless these men and women and have mercy on those who fell defending our children from the Blight. Sadly, one of these heroes has gone missing. Raxel served in Terran Loghaine's vanguard with distinction. Upon his return, his wife said he was prone to quiet reflection and frequented the local taverns. Maybe because he knew something went south with Terran Loghaine, like that there was some sort of betrayal, and so he kept himself and started pondering why they got to survive. Mm-mm-mm. He left his home and never returned. This chanter was moved by the family's grief and is offering a pouch of coin for anyone who finds this hero. The chant says, "In saving one man, you save us all. For if each of us lends a hand to aid his neighbor, anything is possible, especially now. Take it." Fazzle's request. Master Fazzle of the esteemed Guild of Free Sailors has informed this chanter that while about guild business, he was waylaid by bandits via guile and other chicanery. Is that like the word they actually use? Chicanery? Okay, I didn't know that was, I thought that was like a slang word for, he lost many valuables, but in particular, an antique sextant was removed forcibly from his person. The sextant is of considerable symbolic value as it belonged to the first guild master of the Free Sailors. Master Fazzle described his assailants as masked of foreign descent, perhaps Tivinter or Free Marches. What's Free Marches? Is that like a, it's like a Swamplands or something? And unusually coordinated and crafty. He has placed a hefty sum of coin with this chanter for the return of his sextant. That is all. Take it. Loghain's push. What? Loghain's push. Okay, brothers and sisters, word has arrived of an imminent conflict. Taren Loghain's honored forces continue to root out threats to our nation, and their actions deserve support from the common people. Hell no. While it is unusual to post troop movements to the public board, I believe it is necessary for brethren near the affected areas to respect the honored Taren by aiding his troops. Hell no twice. Provide whatever comfort you feel they deserve, and Ferelden will be the stronger for it. Treat those brave soldiers as you would treat Loghain himself, so kill them, and the spiritual rewards will be generous. That one's sketch, but maybe there's some stuff I can pull out of this. Brother Nigel. Alright, let's take all of these, and let's look around the left here. Let's see if I can talk to any of these people. No. Chickens, pumpkins, anything here. Oh, wait, that's right. Let's just do a... There we go. Sister Justine. Oh, wait, no. Wait, can I talk to... Probably. Let's talk to Sister Justine here.
Strange.
They all look alike.
Can be so tumultuous and yet the day still be so bright. Oh, my pardon. Just thinking aloud. Are you here for the Chanter's Board?
I already read it. Who are you? How did you know? What do you do here? Who are you? Why would I ask that right now? How did you know? What do you do here? Why I don't know what to ask. These are simple questions. Who are you? I don't know.
I am Sister Justine, curator of the reliquary of this chantry. And pride again. It is hard to live up to the example of Andraste.
What's the curator do? What are you so proud of? I've got to go. What does the curator do?
The archivist tends the books, and I tend the sacred relics.
The urn?
I also search for more to add to our
urn?
Collection.
Does she know?
It's more difficult than it sounds.
What's so hard about that? There are still relics to be found after all these years. People are selling holy relics on the streets. They are? How would I know that? I don't know that. What's so hard about that? No, that sounds like you're being a dick. And there are still relics to be found after all these years?
My thought exactly. But I'm perpetually amazed at how quickly people accept fantastic claims at face value. A hawker on the street will claim to have an actual finger bone of Andraste. In this city alone, you could make the skeleton of 10 prophets from fingers alone.
Jesus. What's going on? This okay.
Curators often accept what is genuine. There. I worry about the authenticity of even our most holy artifacts.
How difficult is it to verify a relic? Sounds like the hawkers have a good business. Why do other curators fall for it? I've got to go. Sounds like hawk. How difficult is it to verify?
When I was a curator of a much smaller chantry in Orlais, I thought that false relics slipped through because of laziness. But the life of the cloth is never an easy one, and that explanation always seemed hollow to me. Now I believe it's the seduction of the divine. We all want a personal connection to the Maker. We want to believe that what we hold in our hands is the actual sandal that slipped from Andraste's foot before the fires consumed her. Faith is of the heart, not of the head. When the heart is ungoverned by reason, charlatans have powerful tools to deceive.
Right, but how do I know the urn is going to be the real urn at this point? I'd like to talk about something else. Balancing faith and reason is difficult, though. I've got to go. Well, I don't think Xander would get into some sort of theological... talk here. Theology and reason. I like to talk about something else. He can appreciate that's a fine balance. For example...
And often close to heretical.
Forget it.
But I believe that the truth only increases the awe of the Maker and his prophet, not demean it. Even false symbols have the power to inspire. But it seems every year Xander fall more out of touch with the real Andraste.
Xander would agree with that. And where you can go too far is something like the Templars, who are the religious Templars, Crusaders, the killing mages just for whatever, finding simple excuses to take them down. That's where it goes too far. And that's why you gotta have a balance. Could you tell me about your job? How many real relics have you found? Do you think the Urn of Sacred Ashes is real? Bam.
Certainly. My research indicates that all of the ashes were gathered into a pot or urn, but it's been lost for centuries. That doesn't stop hawkers from selling pinches of the ashes of Andraste to gullible pilgrims.
Right.
The real ashes may still be hidden
somewhere. In a temple with wraiths?
No, it's possible the urn broke.
Thank you, Codex. What would you tell me about your... could you tell me about your job? How many real relics have you found? Sure.
Well... there's one that might be real. I couldn't prove it wasn't.
Prove it in this
Perhaps
world.
You can understand my skepticism. So many claims, so few
it's
truths.
It's not like you have to detect magic, you know what I mean? Unless there is. I don't know, but I don't think this world has that sort of thing. Could you tell me about your job? Sure. Last question.
You've shown admirable patience listening to my
diatribe
before. I will not bore you again. Suffice it to say, I look for and authenticate holy relics for the Chantry.
So she's who I come when I find something that might be the urn.
Of course. Enjoy your visit
Sweet.
To the Chantry.
All right, Justine. Templar, go. Okay, why are you guys here? Can you...
In the name of Andraste, Bride of the Maker, be welcome in this house.
I thought they were blocking it.
While the cathedral is closed, if you need to make wedding or funeral arrangements, you'll have to talk to Sister Oma.
Did someone die? I remember a funeral.
King Kaelin died, remember? Along with most of the army at Ostagar? Maker guide them all.
Marriage or funeral? Are people getting married while I play? Like, why is the cathedral closed?
That which you fear. Living in the shadow of death alone. I have seen it is only a cloud passing before
the sun. Is he one of those guys?
The death toll at Ostagar was staggering. We've had a funeral every day for a lost son or daughter of Denerim, and we've many more
you
yet to hold.
You blame for that, buddy? Hmm? What's wrong with your friend?
Are they singing the chant now?
Hmm.
It's a funeral, isn't it?
He should have retired to Valroyo years ago, but he wanted to stay and serve the remainder of his days in his homeland. It's the Lyrium that does this.
Lyrium? Lyrium did this to him? Why doesn't he stop taking it? Why is he taking Lyrium?
He wouldn't be a Templar anymore.
Blessed are they who stand before the corrupt and the wicked and do not falter.
He doesn't forget who he is, even if he can't remember anything else.
I'm so confused. I'm actually confused right now.
May the light of the Maker guide your steps.
When I gather my thoughts. Templars, why are they taking Lyrium? I thought that was a... mage thing. What's over here? Anything over here? I'm always these little cubby holes, man. You never know. You never know. You never know. All right, let's keep going.
Magic exists.
No, I can't. I can't hear you. I think you're hilarious, but I can't. Should I be worried about you, buddy? Oh, Mages Collective. Nah, man.
The client is very
pleased. Let's do this.
Come back soon.
Oh, XP, baby. Boom, boom. Oh, yeah. There we go. Collective friend. Oh, do you have more stuff? Yeah. This thing right here. Let's pick these up. Oh, there's only two. Good. Okay, so the Blood of Warning. How many did I turn in there, actually? I think I did all of them, didn't I? No, I didn't. Blood of Warning. While they tend to be careful and judicious, that word is rough for me, judicious, in their use of force, the Templars do indeed make mistakes. I understand that several relatives of our friends among the collective will soon become targets of the Chantry, and while I trust that this will not lead to lasting harm for those innocents, I wish to ensure that those targets are fairly warned and evacuated before the Chantry can send its message. I ask that a noble soul take the bundle of vials attached to this missive and find the four homes the Chantry is likely to target in Denerim. Oh, cool, it's right here. Mark the front door of each home with the goat's blood from the vials. Those relatives will understand the message and evacuate before the Chantry can threaten them. I love this group, man. Have you seen me? The collective is saddened at the absence of the great mage Reynold. Our friend has not been seen in quite some time, and our gatherings are the lesser for the loss of his tales of Ribald's exploits and the aroma of his delicious twice-baked meat pies. Reynold was last seen traveling in the direction of the Brazilian forest. That's the Brazilian forest where the other mage might have ran to and hid or something like that. I think we have a quest that we have to go there. How did he so love the outdoors? Anyone who returns with evidence of the whereabouts of the beloved mage Reynold will be rewarded. I feel like I'm going to go to the Brazilian forest next. I think I want to do that. Not just for the elf stuff, but I feel like there's a lot of these little quests that are turning up there that we should deal with. And there's more. There's another quest guy here. I'm going to take a look at Sten. So Sten is the kind of guy where, well, I sort of want this up in case I want him up front, but I want him to take that dragon, the set of dragon plate. And I think I can get him. Oh yeah, because he's been leveling up automatically. So I got all these points. I think I need something like 36 or 38 for the dragon armor, something like that. So I'm going to get him up as fast as possible to 38. That's something I'm a little worried about, but I do want him to take that dragon set sooner than later. So I'm going to just commit to 34 strength. I might just do this. This seems like the only sensible thing for me to take and formulate strategies quickly in battle and consequently gains a combat tactics slot. So I get an extra combat tactics slot, which I find useful the more I learn about the AI stuff. I don't really care about any of this. Nope. Just going to get an extra slot next, and then we're going to go bravery. I do like bravery quite a bit, but I'm going to go with the two-handed weapon track, and let's try to get something that will really benefit Alistair up front. The character's fondness of massive two-handed weapons means that each attack offers a chance to stun the opponent. Stun due to the sheer weight behind the blow, and it's passive, so that's every hit can stun. Okay, so I'm heavily leaning on stunning blows. Let's do shattering blows. Character is adept at destruction as at death and gains a large damage bonus against golems and constructs. Cool, haven't really fought many, so let's not worry about that right now. Two-handed strength. The character has learned to wield two-handed weapons more effectively, reducing the penalties to attack and defense from powerful swings. What's powerful swings? This right here. While in this mode, oh, it's a mode. Extra muscle behind each swing, gaining a bonus to damage, but suffering penalties to attack. Okay, so kind of similar sort of things where you give up one thing for another to make another better. Stunning blows. Oh shit, I got two of them. Sweet. Oh my god, hold on. Critical strikes makes a single massive swing at the target. Activated. Okay, gaining a bonus to attack if the strike connects. It is an automatic critical hit, possibly killing the opponent outright if his health is low enough. Yeah, he's going to go straight brawler. Great, straight brawl scrapper. He's in there. He's going to be swinging to damage. And I'll keep him healed. I might actually start really liking Sten. Like, Sten and Zevran. Like, I feel like their sets. Ooh, I feel like getting that right now. Yeah, I'm going to go back there. And hey, Bubby, how you going? I miss Mog already. It's okay. Oh, there's a kitty over there. Funny how they're not. I'm gonna. You know why I'm cautious right now? Not because I'm afraid of a fight, but I'm trying not to overwhelm myself with things to do, because I'm in a new city. And if I start changing directions on things, like not taking lefts, I'm going to disorient myself real quick. So there's an emporium here. This is the guy I really want to talk to. Oh, he's Sergeant Keaton. That's a quest. So hold on. See, I hold on. Let me come back here now. And just tab my way through some of this. There's a wooden crate here. Why is there just no... I'm just going to look in this wooden... Oh yeah, I'll take that. Someone left their healing potion behind. I'll take it. Hooded courier. I'm getting a little... Okay, I'm not going to lie. I'm afraid something's going to start here because of this. I don't know what the hell this is. But I don't like that he's orange. I don't like it. I don't like that he's orange.
My client appreciates your generosity.
Was that part of a quest? Like I had to look for a guy? Probably, right? That would only make sense. Alright, so they're like center. You know what? I'm going to do a full... Oh my god, that centerpiece is just loaded with stuff to do. I'm going to go around the left side here. All the way.
Thank the Maker, my brother and his family made it out of Lothering. He said that the Darkspawn attacked it the very next day.
Okay, there it is.
The Darkspawn took Lothering, did they?
Well, I don't know. I expect so, since there was no one there to stop
them. My friends.
Well, it won't be much longer until those monsters get here. There doesn't seem to be anyone fighting them now.
No.
Maker's blessing to you.
How about you?
Greetings, Maro.
Alright, so yeah. They certainly did take it down, guys. Okay, so what's this right here? Great Warden poster. Is this going to be another set of names? Easter eggs? Don't believe the lies. Friends of the Grey Wardens assemble. Oh. Oh, it's like a secret poster? Like... Oh, I'm liking this. What is this? The Hidden Pearl holds the key to resistance. The Griffins will rise again. What? The Hidden Pearl holds the key to resistance. I gotta keep that in mind. That's probably the name of a bar or the name of a statue or something. The Griffins will rise again. Maybe there's a Griffin statue. I'm in for this. I'm in for this puzzle. Hell yeah, I am. Hell yeah, I am. How about you, little urchin kids? You doing good down there? Need some food? Well, they had their hands up, but they didn't ask me for coins, so... Alright, so... And what do we have back here? We have Jenna TV's house. We have to come for Jenna TV. That's definitely why. Yeah, that's the urn. The urn is tied to Jenna TV. Some other sacred texts, I think, were tied to Jenna TV. He had, like, written the pieces or something. So I think I want to do Jenna TV next. We have a wonder shop. Thetis. What is Thetis? Does that sound... Does that sound like something I've read in a codex? I don't know. We have... Someone else has left their lesser poetess behind. So I'm just going to, you know, pick it up and return it to them whenever I find them. We have a warehouse. Nothing bad has ever happened in a warehouse. Not, you know... I keep thinking of Batman the Animated Series, which was a great series. Early 90s. Bruce Timm. Oh. That was a great, great series. You know what? I feel like stopping here. We have the tavern. Not Noble Tavern. But I want to go in here next episode. I feel like that's going to start off some more of the quest stuff. So, yeah, I'm going to wrap it up here. We got a good time. We made some good time today. So don't forget to explore, engage, inspire, folks. I'll see you around next time. Peace, everybody. This is whenever I see a big place like this, man, I get so intimidated. Looks a little like Riften in Skyrim. Let's...